A seesaw day as Hampshire and Worcestershire play out an evenly contested first day at the Ageas Bowl. Hampshire hosted newly promoted Worcestershire in the first day of the county championship season. Worcestershire elected to bowl and it was subsequently a slow start for the home side. McManus caught behind from a Joe Leach delivery at the end of the second over. The captain, James Vince, was next to the crease and wasted no time picking up runs, hitting boundaries in quick succession. He was looking to perform well in the hope of keeping his England place. With Adams also coming into his stride, the pair were looking dangerous, Vince reaching his 50 off just 49 balls. Shortly after their 100 partnership, Worcestershire made a breakthrough with McGoffin winning an LBW decision against Jimmy Adams. And another huge wicket just before lunch as James Vince is dismissed following a miscued defensive shot. Hampshire went into lunch 140 for 3 with new signings Northeast and Amla at the crease. Northeast continued to bat well, Amla also batting positively. But it's not long before Joe Leach claims his second victim of the day with Northeast bowled out on his Hampshire debut. Three overs later, a disappointing batting display from Russo sees him bowled for 0 after just 10 balls. Dawson was the next to the crease and started well, but it wasn't long before the next wicket, seam bowler Josh Tongue giving Amla a tricky one to deal with, resulting in a huge dismissal by LBW. Berg was next in the crease and wasted no time in adding to the scoreboard, hitting multiple boundaries. Dawson fell next to a perfect delivery from Mitchell, giving him his first wicket of the season. Mitchell then claimed his second wicket off the very next ball, sending Abbott on his way for a golden duck. So the score at tee, 230 for 7. No hat-trick unfortunately for Mitchell, as Wheel safely blocked the first three deliveries after tee, but Wheel was soon sent packing anyway, courtesy of a Tongue delivery. Berg, with partners running out at the other end, upped the tempo, hitting a flurry of boundaries and reaching a 69-ball half-century. With Berg going along nicely, Worcestershire were able to eventually strike at the other end, Edwards the last man to go for one run. So Hampshire finished their first innings on 290 all out. Solid batting displays from Vince and Berg earned them 75 runs each, helping to lift the overall total and leaving Worcestershire some work to do. In response, not the start that Worcestershire were looking for, as D'Oliveira miscues a shot and gives a catch to mid-off from an Edwards delivery, an immediate breakthrough for the West Indian paceman. A slow start for Worcestershire as they had to wait until the seventh over to find their first boundary. Hampshire did strike again. It was Abbott who was able to get through the defences of Tom Fell. Disappointment for Worcestershire, who were trying to see out the day's play without losing another wicket. It brought night watchman Josh Tongue to the middle and he did indeed survive the final over, collecting a boundary off Abbott for good measure. Worcestershire made it to stumps with the loss of two wickets and they will have their work cut out tomorrow after a decent Hampshire batting display. Worcestershire will be looking to Daryl Mitchell to lead the way out in the middle on day two. All in the balance after an entertaining day two at the Ageas Bowl. Hampshire and Worcestershire were the only sides able to enjoy a full day's play on day one yesterday, with weather affecting all the other county championship games. It wasn't a great start though, as Abbott struck with his second delivery of the day to dismiss night watchman Josh Tongue, Russo with the catch in the slips. Didn't take long for another wicket to fall, a loose shot from Tom Mitchell off the bowling of Edwards, Northeast with the catch. Half an hour played, two gone for Worcestershire with only 12 runs added. A substantial batting display was required and Clark looked as if he might have been up to the task with a couple of lovely hits to the boundary. But at the other end, Travis Head was soon to fall for 9 runs, slicing the first ball of a new Berg over into the slips for Sam Northeast to claim his second catch of the innings. More excellent bowling to follow with Berg claiming the wicket of Clark just a few overs later. A beauty from the South African bowler, Clark gone for 20, the visitors in deep trouble at 83 for 6. Cox and Rhodes would safely see Worcestershire pass the 100 mark, Cox in particular playing some expansive shots before lunch. Lunch was called and it was a morning session to savour for Hampshire. 4 wickets for the hosts, putting them firmly in the driving seat. Cox came out with purpose and in one Berg over, he was able to fire 3 boundaries. But Worcestershire's revival was halted as Abbott claimed the wicket of Rhodes, trapping him in front LBW. Ben Cox was to remain undeterred though, as he continued to play his attacking game and ably supported out in the middle by Barnard, and this valuable partnership moved up to 76 runs. But then a breakthrough, and it was Cox who was out for 65, caught Adams' bowled wheel. Skipper Leach came to the crease but didn't last long, Brad Wheel claiming his second victim to leave Worcestershire 9 down. The last man out was Barnard, spinner Liam Dawson claiming his first wicket of the season. Tea was called after Worcestershire were all out, so Hampshire taking a 79-run lead into their second innings. And they got off to a good start with Adams and in particular McManus batting positively. McManus hitting 2 fours and a 6 off one McGoffin over. The swashbuckling start was brought to an end though, as the Hampshire openers were dismissed in successive deliveries. First to go was McManus, before Leach took the ball at the other end and sent Adams on his way. A couple of deliveries later, he struck again, this time northeast bowled out. After a strong start, a sudden wobble for Hampshire. Skipper Vince fell to McGoffin for the second time in the match, but this time with 63 fewer runs against his name. With the hosts 4 down, Russo played a flurry of expansive shots to grab some valuable boundaries. But he was then back in the pavilion, his aggressive batting brought to a close by McGoffin. Another LBW decision then gave Skipper Leach his third wicket of the innings, Liam Dawson the batsman dismissed for 16. Berg managed to collect 2 fours before an LBW decision sent him packing. A big wicket came 2 balls later, as Hashim Amla was run out, the delivery from Tongue towards Abbott resulted in a direct hit from Tom Fell, this potentially being a key moment in the match to look back on. Hampshire ended day 2 at the Ageas Bowl with a lead of 242. Worcestershire will be looking to clean up the rest quickly on day 3 and then bat with discipline to try and mark their return to Division 1 with a victory. Kyle Abbott stars with bat and ball on a rain-affected day at the Ageas Bowl. After a close encounter yesterday, it was all to play for at the Ageas Bowl. Abbott and Wheel started the day well, contributing boundaries for their team. However, it wasn't too long before Wheel was caught out by Clark, the delivery coming courtesy of Ed Barnard. Despite losing his partner, Kyle Abbott continued to bat well, hitting 8 fours in the lead up to his half century, 50 off 69 balls. Unfortunately for the South African, he was caught at first slip not long after the bowling from Barnard, the wicket bringing an end to the innings. So a decent innings for the home side, Abbott a standout player after collecting his 50. They finished on 244 all out, leaving Worcestershire 324 runs to win. Fourth over of Worcestershire's second innings saw Brett D'Oliveira dismissed, the new ball helping Kyle Abbott claim his victim, LBW. Fell did manage to add a couple of boundaries, but not long after, lunch was called. Soon after the break, afternoon play was delayed due to rain. Tom Fell and Daryl Mitchell were in bat for Worcestershire. Both were hoping for an improvement in the weather and a chance to put some runs on the board. Play didn't resume until well after the tea break at about 5:45 p.m. and it didn't take long for Hampshire to strike, Kyle Abbott not letting an almost 5-hour rain interruption affect his rhythm, clean bowling Tom Fell for 8. Clark and Mitchell then upped the ante with some hits to the boundary. But then a big wicket, Kyle Abbott jagged one back off the seam, Joe Clark on his way, LBW with just 5 overs left of the day. Josh Tongue entered the fray as night watchman, as Worcestershire saw it through to close without further loss. It looks to be an enthralling day 4 set up tomorrow, as Worcestershire will look for the 265 runs left to claim victory. Hampshire will fancy their chances of finding the 7 wickets they need. It's all up for grabs at the Ageas Bowl. Newly promoted Worcestershire well beaten by Hampshire. Hampshire closed the day well yesterday, securing a lead of 264 runs with 7 Worcestershire wickets remaining, the away side facing a tricky run chase on day 4 at the Ageas Bowl. The third over saw the first wicket of the day, Berg removing Josh Tongue after a wayward shot found the hands of Brad Wheel. Not what Worcestershire needed in the following over. Mitchell trapped LBW from an Abbott delivery, a fourth wicket for the South African at this stage. Travis Head was new to the crease and he batted well, finding the boundary on various occasions. His partner George Rose, however, not managing to get past the one-run mark. Edwards getting the wicket, Amler with the catch. Worcestershire's hopes were fading at this point. The next over resulted in Ben Cox being sent on his way, courtesy of a wheel delivery. He went for a duck after the ball was sent smashing into off stump. Efficient bowling from Hampshire resulted in a devastating following over, Fidel Edwards pinning Barnard LBW. Joe Leach then caught behind for a duck off the very next ball. Worcestershire saw the final dismissal 10 overs later, spinner Liam Dawson finding the wicket of McGoffin, caught by the captain James Vince at mid-wicket. Worcestershire finished on 127, resulting in a Hampshire win by 196 runs. So a convincing win for Hampshire, efficient bowling efforts from the home side helping them to victory. Kyle Abbott the standout with 4 for 45, giving him match figures of 7 for 90. Worcestershire starting their life in Division 1 with a loss, only three of their batsmen reaching double figures in their second innings. Hampshire collect 21 points, Worcestershire with 4.